Hey everyone, I'm trying to mute you guys. But it's not letting me. I don't know why. It's very weird. I see participants. Oh, wait. Here we go. Here y'all. You are all muted. Let me admit you guys. I'm in my pajamas. My jail pajamas. All right, I'm just going to keep letting people in. It says recording, and I cleared out all my stuff. So hopefully, this does record. Jennifer, don't look at the video, just listen. I see you driving. All right, we're gonna give it one more minute. Making sure nobody's messaging me. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get started with the meeting. So, welcome everybody to week two. I'm going to go over some housekeeping things, and then I had asked for a couple of people if they wanted to give words of wisdom, advice, how long they've been. So you say your name, how long you've been with the program, what you've done so far with the program, and one word of advice. And we went through and we had a couple of people, I think three or four last week. And I said today we'll do another two, and then I'll get started on the meeting. Hold on one second. Alexa, Island Lights white. Sorry, whoever has an Alexa. Okay. So first thing for housekeeping is I go on my trip on Wednesday of next week. So we're going to have our weekly meeting on Tuesday after the workout. So the workout will be 6:15 and the meeting will be at 7. And I will do a post And the workout will only happen if there's enough people to do the workout. And then meeting at 7:15. I'm just making myself a note. Because then I'll be away. And there will be no meeting on Wednesday, the 7th. Because I'll be on the cruise. Okay. So that's that. So next thing I want to talk about is if you have MyFitnessPal and you don't have the premium, starting October 1st, you won't be able to scan your items. They're only allowing that for premium. So I'm going to tell everybody to start scanning everything so that you have it in your phone. So when you can't scan anymore, but you could still enter it, like you could still scroll and reach for whatever it is you're looking for. You just can't, you know, scan it. They are giving you half off the first year if you choose to upgrade. So it's like $37 or $38. And I am offering to pay half of that if you want to stay in MyFitnessPal with the scanning. You also have the option of going to in-app tracking, which a lot of people are loving, or you can do Fitbit. So any of those will do. It's not till October 1st. So you don't have to start messaging me and all that stuff. I wouldn't even do it right till the end so that you have that full year of the premium upgrade, right? So that's that. Wanted to get that out of the way. So the next thing I want to talk about, and I probably will talk about this till like beat a dead horse or till I'm blue in the face or whatever it is, but I give you your macros because that is not an it's not an option. Like your numbers are your numbers. So if you message me and say, well, I did all I can, I'm going to leave 64 proteins. Then I'm going to say, you're not doing the program and I'll be happy to refund you. Like my strategy of being a coach is I like a 99% success rate. I like 100, but doesn't always work that way. I like to see everybody succeed. And as a coach, that's my goal. But if you're not going to do the program, I don't want you in the program. And I'm not trying to be mean and I'm not trying to be a bitch. I just, there's no point in you doing the program if you're not going to do it. If you're just going to message me and say, well, I left 22 fats, but it's not a big deal. I left 17 carbs, but I'm okay with that. I'm not. And I'm in charge. I'm the coach. And I'm telling you guys the numbers you need to eat. And I'm giving you all 10 grams over under. That is all you get. The program is 10 carbs over under, fat 6. If you don't want to do it, message me and I will send you your money back in a heartbeat. And I'm not trying to be mean. I don't know if I'm doing tough love, but I'm getting messages from the same people every single day. I have 36 carbs left, but I'm okay with that. I really didn't want to eat those. I went over 17 fats, but you know what? Today's a new day. Yes, today's a new day, but don't continually do it. Because then you message me and wonder why the scale's not moving. And it's because you're not hitting your macros. You're tracking macros to hit your macros, to see the scale move, to see your body fat go down. And if you don't do the work, you're not going to get the results. It's just, that's how it is. I mean, I track my macros every single day, every day. There's not a day I do not track my macros. There's not a day that I'm not within usually 4 to 6 of protein, carbs, and fats. Because I know it works, because I know what my goals are. And I know that's how you track macros. And the most important macro is protein. That is the number one protein you have to hit. That is your priority every single day, is to hit those proteins. And reach out to me. Let me help you reach those. Don't say, well, I couldn't hit them. It was already 8 o'clock at night, so I just figured I would go to bed. Well, why don't you just message me at 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon? And say, hey, I know I'm going to be short on my proteins. What can I do? That's why I'm here. And I mean, we're only 1 week really in officially. And this is your opportunity to get on the program, to change your lifestyle. Exercising is not going to change your body the way you want it to. You cannot out-exercise a bad diet. It doesn't happen. Believe me, I freaking work out all day long. You all see me gain a little weight, drop a little weight. It's just you see it. If that was the truth, I would probably be this big. But I'm not. Because exercising does not change your body the way you want it to. It helps, for sure. But getting on the treadmill for 8 miles because you ate a pumpkin cupcake or had a pumpkin spice latte is not going to do it. So please remember that. I've been getting so many messages like that. And I feel like I didn't reinforce how the program works, maybe. And then I feel like I did. So then I feel like I'm not doing my coaching job. So that's that. All right. So who has been on the program? Like, Stacey, did you talk last week? No, because you weren't on, right? Okay. And then Caroline, put your hand up, or Christine, put your hand up, Delgado, if either of you would be interested in talking. You don't have to come on video, just speaking. You will? After you eat?
Yeah.
My sister go, and then you can go next, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Stacey. So you're going to say your name. Everybody knows it now. You're going to say your name, where you're from, how long you've been doing the program, how far you've come, and what you do to achieve your goal.
Okay. I'm Stacey, and I've been in the program since September. I think it's the 6th. So not quite a year yet. I really struggled in the beginning a lot. I was like, why did I do this to myself? And now I can't imagine another way of living. I just love it. For a while there, I thought it was like magic, the way things finally started to work and come together for me. I enjoy playing macros Tetris now. I've lost Monday's weigh-in. I lost 70 pounds as of Monday. It's a little crazy to think that. I never thought I'd get to this point. I have 30 more that I'd like to lose, and then I'll decide where I am body-wise. I'm watching my body fat, and I never thought I'd work out. I just didn't have the time, really wasn't into it. And so I did her band workouts because I was like, okay, they're free and they're really cool and I can fit that in. And then something happened and now I want to work out more. So it's kind of weird to me. But I enjoy working out. We now have a treadmill in the house and a recumbent bike. And one of the things that I would really suggest, there's a couple of things. You have to stay engaged. You have to be involved. The free classes, and they're really priceless. So when she offers those free workouts, the bands and the hits, take it. It's the best thing you can do for yourself because it's really like having private training. She'll tell you what you're doing right or wrong, and she really pushes you. And I love the workouts. The other thing is planning your meals. I like planning my meals ahead. I plan typically on Sunday from Monday through Thursday, with giving myself a little flexibility later in the week to plan on Friday, Saturday, Sunday. But I always plan my meals ahead. This was my first vacation away with my husband since September. And I found it very hard to plan when we were away. But we cut the trip shorter because I wanted to get back and get back on to what I was doing. It makes me happier. It regulates me. And I just wanted to be back in my own house doing what I was doing. So as soon as I knew this morning we were coming back, so I knew what I was having for breakfast. And on the car ride, I planned the rest of my day. And I feel good and happy because now I'm back to the way I like it.
And so, you don't get any special treatment, right?
No, none at all.
You all should know me. I don't give anybody special treatment. If anything, I'm probably harder on her than anyone, but I'm actually really not. She's been doing it on her own. So I'm super proud of you. And it only took you how many years, but you're here and you're doing it. And that's what's important, right? All right. Caroline, you're up next.
Okay. First of all, 70 pounds is amazing. Congratulations. I'm like floored. Wow. 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 Good for you. Good for you. So I'm Caroline. I started with Shannon doing this program 2 years ago this month. It was during the pandemic And I thought, if it's not happening now, it's never going to happen. Thought I was burning something. Sorry. And yeah, you know, cause I always work out. I always walk. I always watch what I eat and denied myself desserts and such, but it just, the weight kept creeping on and it was all about the macros and the balance for me. And at first I was like, I have to eat all this food. This is a lot of food, but the weight came off and, 25 pounds I lost. I joined just to lose 10 pounds. I didn't know I had 25 pounds to lose. This summer, I kind of not fell off, but I was traveling a lot this summer. I was gone most of the summer, so it was really hard for me to track. That was, is my challenge, is traveling, traveling. I don't know. So I gained 5 pounds. I'm good with for the whole summer, 5 pounds. I'm pretty good with that. So I'm back on track and here I am.
Awesome. And you brought family members in with you?
I sure. Yep. My sister-in-law, my brother-in-law, my husband, my son should be here. I don't know where he is right now, but yeah. And friends, lots of friends.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And I appreciate you speaking. There's always going to be a common theme. Nobody ever realized that they could eat so much food. And that the more you eat, the weight just falls off. And that's so important to keep remember all the time, because we starve ourselves, we restrict ourselves, and that's when our body will hold on to your fat, to hold on to what you want to let go of. And your own body's self-sabotaging you, because you think in your mind that, if I don't eat all these carbs that China's telling me to eat, I'm going to lose weight a lot faster. I'm going to speed up this process. But it doesn't work like that. Unfortunately, I wish it did, but it doesn't. And same thing with, you know, the proteins and the fats. You need to eat exactly what you're being told to eat in numbers, because the weight will fall off. The second thing is being consistent and engaged. Caroline and my sister, before Caroline went all over the summer, but it was in every meeting. And it's great to watch them on replay if you have to, because they're there sometimes. Sometimes they don't, doesn't work when I try to, last week it recorded and then it wouldn't let me convert it. So I don't know what was going on. I'm praying today that it will go through. But being on and being engaged, it's like going to an AA meeting. It just keeps you in the right mindset. And that's why I do these meetings. And then as far as the workouts, it's another, just another way of staying engaged and seeing like-minded people doing what you're doing. You know, last week there was like 7 or 8 people on, which was freaking awesome. And then this week I had the crickets. So, and it was kind of bummer to me, because even though I worked out twice yesterday, I was looking forward to doing it, but, I didn't know what to do. So I didn't do it. I got on the treadmill, I ran 3 miles, but it didn't replace it at all. But I had planned to do something and I was like, all right, well, what am I gonna do now? So I got on the treadmill. All right. So there was a really good meeting that didn't record, and it was about self-sabotage. I can't redo a meeting because I don't even know what I said in that meeting about self-sabotage, to be totally honest with you, because I have so much information in my head that I just share. But I want you guys to think about what self-sabotage is. Sabotaging your diet means that you want to lose weight, but in the moment you want something more. A cookie, a glass of wine, don't feel like going for your walk, out with friends and you're like, screw it, I'm going to have nachos because I deserve it. Those are all self-sabotage, believe it or not. Even if you're allowing yourself to do it, just because it's conscious doesn't mean that you're not sabotaging yourself. Oh, Jennifer, I'm glad you're not driving anymore. There are certain things that will trigger your self-sabotage. So if there's foods that you should not have in your house, you need to get them out, especially if you live alone. Because there's nobody you're having it for except yourself. And then you're self-sabotaging yourself. And if you have somebody that you live with, if they want you to succeed, chances are they're going to be okay with it. Like my house, when I moved into Mike's house, he had more crap in this house than you could possibly think of. Like before I even moved in, I had to like de-mic the food pantry, and his girls had everything in here. And he used to snack before he would go to bed and not even realize it. I would wake up and I would just see like Oreo, those little Oreo sleeves. And I would say, Mike, did you even know you ate this stuff before you went to sleep? And he's like, no. He's like, I fell asleep on the couch. I got up. I ate it. It was probably 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning and I went to bed. I would find wrappers in the bathroom because he would probably go to pee and put the wrapper on the windowsill and didn't realize it. But the food was in the house. So now there's none of that. If he's going to snack on something, it's going to be something healthy. And then I'm fine with it. Although if I see like 2 or 3 of them, then we have an issue. One morning I woke up, there was 3 Yasso bar wrappers. They weren't mine. So now I have to count stuff too. I'm like, all right, I know there's 8 Yasso bars in here. When I wake up in the morning, the bread will only be set. There'd be 7. So I kind of hold them accountable. But if you're living with someone, let them know what your goals are. Tell them how important it is to you. And chances are they're going to say, okay, you know, don't buy that anymore. Or screw you. I really want to have it. And I'm not on that program. And if that's the case, have them hide it from you. I do that a lot too. You know, Christmas time, I talk about this. Mike buys from Crate and Barrel, I think it is, or one of those, the tins of peppermint bark. And he has our names engraved on it. And he thinks it's like this great thing on the tin. And then I get it. I'm like, I'm not going to eat it. And he's like, well, I bought it for you. So we'll just leave it in the pantry. Okay. Do you not think if I'm sitting on the couch that tin's going, Shannon, come eat me. 100%. So I have to make him hide it so I don't know where it is. And then I'll say, okay, I allowed myself this much in my app. You can take it out, but don't let me see where you're getting it from. I do that all the time with stuff that he brings in that I can't have. Right now, there's probably things hidden all over the place. I have no idea. I also had a principal who had 3 young kids, and they had the Doritos for school and all that other stuff. So she bought a Tupperware, and she put the lock on her Tupperware and locked it away and gave her oldest child the key and said, put the key somewhere. So she had to have the food in the house. And then when she was giving it their lunches and stuff like that, they would take it out. I don't know if you guys remember Robera, but it was like 2 or 3 years ago. But she reached her goal and she's been maintaining, which is freaking awesome. So figure out what you're doing that is makes you self-sabotage. Is it that you're bored? Because boredom definitely will bring out self-sabotaging habits. Sitting on the couch, I'm bored. I'm going to get up and have something to eat. Well, what are you going to eat? Do you have room in your daily budget for that? If not, go for a walk. Do a plank. Do push-ups. Do bridges. Do squats. Something to get your mind off of that boredom. And then go back to what you were doing in your pipe. If you're not truly hungry, and it's just because it's a habit or you're bored, you probably won't eat that food. The reason why we don't have restrictions and the reason why we track macros is because it's flexible. And you shouldn't have to self-sabotage yourself. If there's something you know you have to have every single day, and maybe it's not that great for you, maybe it's that piece of Dove chocolate that I talk about, that client all the time. She put it in her app. So then she's not self-sabotaging herself because she's already accounted for it. She knows she wants to have it. She's putting it in her app. She's allowing herself to have it. And you're not on restriction and you're not on a diet. But when you start treating it like that, that's when you start to self-sabotage and have those habits. One impulse decision is very slippery going down that slope. Remember, it's all an impulse. It's not something you're really thinking about. It's not something that you, when you think about making dinner, it's like instantly you're thinking about this and it could be gone within that instant as well. And I talk about putting a rubber band on your ass. If you snap it, I'm going to go upstairs. If you snap that rubber band, sometimes I get done. I don't have to. When you snap that rubber band, it totally changes your way of thinking. So I used to go to counseling, therapy, whatever you want to call it. And She used to say, anytime I would think about, like bad habits, or I got mad at my ex-husband for something he did, she would always say, snap. What's going on here? Hold on a second. Sorry. She would always say, snap the rubber band. Get that thought out of your head. It's no longer going to serve you. I don't know what's going on here. Hopefully you guys can see me. It's no longer going to serve you, and it will be out of your head. So for probably a year and a half, I would do this all the time. Don't hurt yourself, but that gets that thought out of your head. So if you're constantly wanting crappy food, constantly wanting to self-sabotage yourself, get a hairband, get a rubber band. It will definitely help you to get out of that thought process. And once you change that thought process, you'll move on to the next thing. Okay, so when you eat like highly satiating foods, so foods that really fill you up, and you're not picking throughout the day to hit your macros, will help you not self-sabotage because you're full. But if you eat very little meals throughout the day, you're always waiting for that next meal. You're always waiting for that next snack. But if you just bulk it all up and maybe have three or four, you're not going to be thinking about food because you're full from what you just ate. And by the time it's ready for your next meal, you get another big meal. So that's a really good trick, not even just with self-sabotage, but it's a great trick for you guys to get all your macros in by bulking it all together. If you were to constantly piecemeal throughout the day, then you're always waiting to eat again and thinking about what you're going to eat. And at that point, your sugar cravings are going to go up and you're going to self-sabotage yourself. Unfortunately, when we're sad, we'll self-sabotage ourselves, and we call that comforting ourselves. There's other ways to comfort yourself. Call a friend, text a friend, go for a walk, reach out to me. If you're mad at somebody, don't say, that just pissed me off. I'm going to drink this glass of wine. I don't care if I don't have the macros. You're hurting yourself. Jen, do you do that? Yes. You're hurting yourself doing that. So think about what you're doing. When you get that trigger and you're ready to do it, write it down. Put it on a calendar. Every time you get that self-sabotage, put like a red circle. And then look at that calendar of how many red circles you have. Or maybe it's a certain time of day. And what are you doing at that time of day every time that you need this? Like, what's happening in your life? Who's pissing you off in the office? What are you doing during the day? Are you reading emails? Is your boss pissing you off? All those things do not mean or give you a reason to binge or cheat, because it's not in your daily budget that you accounted for. And then you are self-sabotaging yourself. A lot of times we self-sabotage ourselves because we're afraid of the outcome at the end of reaching our goal. What do I do now? I reached my goal. I have nothing else to do. That's me. That's me in a nutshell. Every time I get to like 16 to 17% body fat, I'm like, shit, I don't have a goal anymore. What am I going to do now? And then I go back up to 18%. I'm like, all right, I could start all over again. Like, it's self-sabotage because I'm afraid of reaching that goal, right? I gave an example one time of somebody that wanted a date, and they kept saying, I want to reach my goals so I can date. I want to have a boyfriend, whatever. But as they started getting closer to their goal, they started self-sabotaging themselves because the fear of the unknown. What if I start dating and I don't meet somebody? What if I don't meet anybody on the app? What if everybody I meet are assholes? Am I doing this? What am I doing this for? And that ultimate goal of reaching your goal will cause you to self-sabotage yourself. So you need to start thinking about, why are you doing this? What is your why? Which I didn't open that group up yet because I wanted to have this meeting first. And I'll open it up again for all the new people. And you're going to put the reason why you're in this program. And you can read other people's reasons. And every time you feel like you want to self-sabotage yourselves, I want you to think about that reason that you put in there. Someone once said, I want to reach this goal because it'll help me get my promotion. We all know that's not true, right? You know, it's you're putting that barrier up that that's why you're not getting the promotion. But hopefully in our day and age, you losing weight is not going to get you the promotion. You working harder is going to get you the promotion. But what happens is then we start worrying, what if I get this promotion and I have to work harder? What if I can't get to the gym? What if I don't have time in the morning to meal prep? And then you start self-sabotaging yourself. So it's not just about wanting food. It's the feelings. It's the thought process behind that self-sabotage that we all need to do. I need to do it too. We all need to practice being aware of it and not allowing those triggers to take over. Being aware is the total key in stopping that self-sabotage. Taking charge would help you stay away from that self-sabotage. If you are more structured, if you are more habitual, which is why we have habits, will help you not self-sabotage. I'm going to talk about a couple of things that will trigger self-sabotage and maybe you guys can stay away from those things. The first thing is, and this is really funny because, and I've told the story too. When I first started coming to Mike's house, I had never in my whole world ever watched a Food Channel TV show. Never, ever, ever. I knew they existed, but I never turned the TV on to watch that. I started coming to Mike's house. That nobody could be even in the room, but I would come in and there would be a Food Channel show on. And that was like him and his daughter's thing. They would watch the Food Channel Network or whatever those things are. Dive in ditches and I don't know, whatever the hell it's called. And that right there is self-sabotage. Why the hell would you watch food all day, right? So I walk into the gym yesterday at Retro Fitness and I'm training a client. I look up. And it's the freaking Food Network. I was like, are you kidding me? And it wasn't even food. It was dessert. So I walked right up to the front. I was like, to Ed, the owner, I'm like, you need to change the TV. I don't care if you want to play Christian music all day long because he does that. I don't care what you do, but you need to change that television. Because that in itself, he was sabotaging other people. But if you do that at your house, stop it. Turn the Food Network off. Also, Pinterest and Instagram are triggers for self-sabotage. Oh, that dessert looks great. I might have to make that this weekend. Stay away from that. Lingering in the pantry after you eat a meal. We talked about that. Things that will trigger your hunger, salty nuts. So if you guys have nuts in your, he's wrapping something over the tape. If you have like nuts in your budget for the day, do eat that when you know that you're not self-sabotageable. So if you look at your calendar that you marked off and you realize every time you eat those nuts, they make you want more food that's not good for you, try not to do that. There was a good example. I was going through Instagram today. I'm going back to Instagram, Pinterest, but I was going through Instagram today and someone posted, what was it? Cookies of Instagram. I immediately clicked on it. It was a hashtag. And it was all these incredible cookies. And of course, now my mind's like, oh my God, I can really use a cookie. I didn't get one. But I could have self-sabotaged myself and gotten it, but I totally forgot about that today. And I looked down at my notes and I had a note for that. What are your trigger foods? Pretzels could be a trigger food for you. Fruit snacks, granola bars. Those are naturally known as trigger foods. So if you find yourself eating those and then wanting more of something that's not good for you, stay away from those. Anything sweet will increase your cortisol level, which will make you crave sugar. Keep that in mind. So if you allow yourself something sweet, know that it's probably going to make you want more sweets. It's just, that's how it is. If you allow yourself to have a chocolate bar, your body's going to want more of that chocolate bar. I talked about boredom will cause self-sabotage. If you're not that type of person that could eat the same thing all the time, change it up. Get in that recipe group. Look at my recipe book. Get that app we talked about. Think about your excuses. Well, I'm bored, or everyone says that I shouldn't restrict myself. Well, you don't. So don't play that game in your head that you're under restriction, because you're not. Everybody needs a cheat day. There are no needs for cheat days. Even athletes have cheat days, but we don't need one. One bite won't matter. It does matter. Every bite matters. I'm going to get cut off here really quick. My body needs a break from dieting. We're not dieting. So allow yourself the foods. If you feel like you are self-sabotaging yourself, send me a message. I don't want to get cut off. Send me a message and we need to talk about it in detail further. Next week, we're going to be talking about sharing foods that we love, favorite foods. So please start thinking about that. I'm going to put it in the group. Wow, I talked a lot today. I didn't realize that was so much. So I hope you guys all have an amazing Wednesday night. I will see you next Tuesday for our meeting and the workout. Bye, everyone. Remember, always be badass. Thank you, Stacey and Chris, Caroline, for talking today. I'll be reaching out for more people next week. Bye, everyone. Let's pray that it records.